Come, O come, Emmanuel, and ransom captive Israel that mourns in lowly exile here, until the Son of God appear. Rejoice, rejoice, O Israel, to thee shall come Emmanuel.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. My brothers and sisters, it is good for us to be here to worship the one true God. In order for us to prepare our hearts, our minds, and our souls, let us first acknowledge our sins. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy. You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Pour forth, we beseech you, O Lord, your grace into our hearts, that we to whom the incarnation of Christ your Son was made known by the message of an angel, may by his passion and cross be brought to the glory of his resurrection, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the second book of Samuel. Now when David, the king, was settled in his house, and the Lord had given him rest from all his enemies around him, the king said to the prophet Nathan, "See now, I am living in a house of cedar, but the ark of God stays in a tent." Nathan said to the king, "Go, do all that you have in mind, for the Lord is with you." But that same night, the word of the Lord came to Nathan, "Go and tell my servant David, thus says the Lord, are you the one to build me a house to live in? I took you from the pasture, from following the sheep, to be prince over my people Israel. And I have been with you wherever you went, and have cut off all your enemies from before you. And I will make for you a great name, like the name of the great ones of the earth. And I will appoint a place for my people Israel, and will plant them so that they may live in their own place and be disturbed no more. And evildoers shall afflict them no more, as formerly, from the time that I appointed judges over my people Israel, and I will give you rest from all your enemies. Moreover, the Lord declares to you, David, that the Lord will make you a house. When your days are fulfilled and you lie down with your ancestors, I will raise up your offspring after you, who shall come forth from your body, and I will establish his kingdom. And I will be a father to him, and he shall be a son to me. Your house and your kingdom shall be made sure forever before me. Your throne, David, shall be established forever." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I will sing of your steadfast love, O Lord. Forever I will sing of your steadfast love, O Lord. I will sing of your steadfast love, O Lord, forever. With my mouth I will proclaim your faithfulness to all generations. I declare that your steadfast love is established forever. Your faithfulness is as firm as the heavens. Forever I will sing of your steadfast love, O Lord. You said, I have made a covenant with my chosen one. I have sworn to my servant David, I will establish your descendants forever and build your throne for all generations. Forever I will sing of your steadfast love, O Lord. He shall cry to me, you are my Father, my God, and the rock of my salvation. Forever I will keep my steadfast love for him, and my covenant with him will stand firm. Forever I will sing of your steadfast love, O Lord.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, to the one who is able to strengthen you, according to my gospel and the proclamation of Jesus Christ, according to the revelation of the mystery, that was kept secret for long ages, but is now disclosed, and through the prophetic writings is made known to all Gentiles, according to the command of the eternal God, to bring about the obedience of faith to the only wise God through Jesus Christ, to whom be the glory forever. Amen. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia. Alleluia, 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 alleluia. Here am I, the servant of the Lord. Let it be done to me according to your word. Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary. And he came to her and he said, "Hail, full of grace, the Lord is with you." But she was much perplexed by his words and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give to him the throne of his father David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I am a virgin?" The angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be holy. He will be called Son of God. And now your relative Elizabeth, in her old age, has also conceived a son. And this is the sixth month for her who was said to be barren. For nothing is impossible with God." Then Mary said, Here am I, servant of the Lord. Let it be done to me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
I have to tell you, it's truly a gift to be able to speak to you today on the glory of God through the Annunciation of the angel Gabriel to the Blessed Virgin Mary. This is the single greatest message of all time. The gospel reading announces the incarnation, God becoming man, joining us in this world. God himself took on a human life experience, conception, birth, infancy, childhood, even death. It's a reminder to us all of God's unending love for each of us and his example that shows us the way to a meaningful life now and forever. God wants to be intimately involved in our lives. This gospel reading reminds us that God seeks our cooperation. God invites Mary to become the mother of the Savior. Mary had a choice. It was possible for her to reject this invitation. Mary could have said, "Thank you, Lord, for the invitation, but what you're asking is actually not good for me right now." Or if you wanted to hear a more modern response, "I'm sorry, Lord, but I'm just too busy right now." But that's not how she answered. Mary knew God. She knew that his plans are always wise and always wonderful. So she put her life at her service. Her response, "I am the handmaid of the Lord. May it be done unto me according to your word." Mary said yes. And Mary's yes reversed Adam and Eve's no. It is essential in our modern day world that we don't make light of the enormity of this moment in the history of all of mankind. This is not just a little cute Bible story. This is challenging. Answering yes had immediate ramifications to Mary's life, and she could not have known the struggle or the challenges, the difficulties that came with accepting God's call. But then Mary didn't look at it from that point of view at all. When Mary accepted the request from the angel, the only question Mary had is, wasn't what's this going to do to me? Her question was simply, how do I respond to a request from the Lord? The only question Mary had is, who am I that the Lord would call me? When God disrupts our plans, we need to follow Mary's example, making our contribution to God's work of salvation, however small that may be. Salvation, for all of us, it's God's business. But it's a partnership. We have a role to play as well. Jesus' reflection on this world, even today, is presented through you and I. Jesus enters into the world when we speak words of kindness. Jesus enters into our world when we give comfort to others, when we hold the hand of those who are suffering, when we make space in our homes, in our hearts, in our church, for those who need a place to belong. Christmas is not merely a reminder that Jesus was born 2,000 years ago. Christmas in 2020 is here so that you and I have an opportunity to allow Jesus Christ to be born in you and I. We are God's chosen people. God is calling each and every one of us, adults, seniors, youth, and children, and he is inviting us to represent Jesus Christ to every single person we meet through the way we treat one another, through simple acts of faith and kindness and charity. But we have to say yes. In our response to Christ's call to us, many of us may ask the same question that Mary had, but who am I? And we all have a purpose in this life. We all are invited to allow Christ to be born through us. And we all will respond one way or the other. This gospel reading is inviting us to answer yes. The journey through Advent reminds us, do not be afraid. Dare to respond yes to God's call. If you open your heart to God's call, if you do truly respond yes to his will, if you cooperate with God, watch. Watch. Watch for all the pieces to fall together. When you allow Jesus to be born through you, when you say yes to God, watch for peace to envelop your life and joy to fill your heart. Watch for hope to reign supreme and love to fill you and all of those around you. We're all struggling, every one of us, through this pandemic. Many of us won't see our children or our grandchildren or family members this Christmas. But if you respond to God, as Mary did, if you dare to say yes to God's call, I promise you, this Christmas will be the greatest Christmas of your life.
Brothers and sisters, let us, in response to God's word, let us proudly respond to God's love for each and every one of us by professing our faith in the words of the Nicene Creed. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father for all ages. God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried and rose again on the third day. In accordance with the scriptures, he ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. As we await with longing the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ, dear brothers and sisters, let us with renewed devotion beseech his mercy, that as he came into the world to bring good news to the poor, and to heal the contrite of heart, so in our own time also, he may bring salvation to all in need.
The intention for today's Mass is for Alphonse Mahieu by the Knights of Columbus, and for the souls in purgatory by the Kuna family. We pray for Pope Francis, Archbishop Marcel, all priests, deacons, and religious, that they will continue to faithfully proclaim the good news. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For a listening heart, that our hearts may be stilled and quieted so that we may hear the word of God as it comes to us in our everyday lives, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us gathered, that we, like Mary, may ponder God's invitations and give our full yes to all that God asks of us. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who have and continue to work so hard to protect us from the pandemic, that we may show respect for their efforts by following their recommendations this Christmas season, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are isolated and alone, particularly those who are homebound or in nursing homes, that Christ may fill their emptiness and open our hearts to reach out to them, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick among our families and friends, especially Ernie Philip, Bridget Lever, Zach Brownrigg, Brenda Rose, Kathleen Kendall, Bernice Monroe, Doris McDonald, Kathleen Lacroix, Rob Patterson, Caleb Hodge, Art Smith, Sharon Pesci, and any others who are ill but not included by name, may Christ bless them and heal them. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, especially Dorothy Shaughnessy, Aaron Holt, Father Hugh McNeil, and Scott Hudson, may Christ welcome them into eternal glory. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Almighty ever-living God, who brings salvation to all and desire that no one should perish, hear the prayers of your people and grant that the course of our world may be directed by your peaceful rule, and your church rejoice in tranquility and devotion through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we've received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God.
Humble spirit and contrite heart, accepted by you, O Lord, and may our sacrifice in your sight this day be pleasing to you, Lord God. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy children.
Amen. May the Holy Spirit, O Lord, sanctify these gifts laid upon your altar, just as he filled with his power the womb of the Blessed Virgin Mary, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For all the oracles of the prophets foretold him. The Virgin Mother longed for him with love beyond all telling. John the Baptist sang of his coming and proclaimed his presence when he came. It is by his gift that already we rejoice at the mystery of his nativity, so that he may find us watchful in prayer and exultant in praise. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest,
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an everlasting offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, Saint Faustina, and all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis our Pope and Marcel our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Let us offer one another a sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Oh, grant us, grant us peace.
Lord Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, whom by the will of the Father and the Holy Spirit, through your death gave life to the world, free me by his most holy body and blood from all my sins and from every evil, keep me always faithful to your commandments and never let me be parted from you. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body of Christ keep me safe for eternal life.
During this time, when we are unable to receive the Eucharist, you are encouraged to make an act of spiritual communion. You are invited to join me. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace. The Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of death. Amen. Gentle woman, quiet light, morning star, so strong and bright. Gentle mother, peaceful dove, teach us wisdom, teach us love. You were chosen by the Father. You were chosen for the Son. You were chosen from all women and for women, shining one, gentle woman, quiet light, morning star, so strong and bright. Gentle mother, peaceful dove, teach us wisdom, teach us love. Blessed are you among women, blessed in turn all women too. Blessed they with peaceful spirits, blessed they with gentle hearts. Gentle woman, quiet light, morning star, so strong and bright. Gentle mother, peaceful dove, teach us wisdom, teach us love. Teach us wisdom, teach us love.
Let us pray. Having received this pledge of eternal redemption, we pray, Almighty God, that as the feast day of our salvation draws ever nearer, so we may press forward all the more eagerly to the worthy celebration of the mystery of your Son's Nativity, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Let us go in peace, glorifying the Lord by the way we live our lives.
Thanks be to God. St. Michael the Archangel, defend us in the day of battle. Be our safeguard against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all evil spirits who prowl through the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen.
I, the Lord of sea and sky, I have heard my people cry, all who dwell in dark and sin, my hand will save. I who made the stars of night, I will make their darkness bright. Who will bear my light to them? Whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord. Is it I, Lord? I have heard you calling in the night. I will go if you lead me. I will hold your people in my I will